And good evening. Welcome to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with my lovely co-host, Samantha Caldwell. We'd like to welcome you to Comcast Studio 25 tonight. How are you doing tonight?
We are well tonight. It's an amazing evening.
I won't tell them that you just got here, but, you know, I thought I'd just let it slip out. That
no,
you
don't
did.
Do that. See, don't they do that? They think I've been here for hours.
Okay, so how was your day?
I have had a great day, a very busy day, because I was out of town last week.
Oh, okay, yeah. So has it been very hot for you?
Oh my goodness,
yeah,
this heat,
yes,
you know,
we gotta do something.
Well,
supposedly it will rain on Sunday, which will be good. Well, we have a great show tonight.
Yes,
and
we're
gonna
great
take
lineup.
A quick break and come back because we have some great people and an author. We have a new person that's coming into our community with a nail bar. I'm gonna let her tell you all about what she does.
Yeah.
And then we had a great musical guest. I understand it's a tribe or a family.
Yes, a family tribe.
Yeah,
a tribe,
so
a family.
We'll see what we got. Mm-hmm. All right. We'll take a quick break. You watch the Stan Watson Show. I promise you we'll be right back.
Body language. Without saying a word, can tell you so much. Like someone is having a stroke. Know the sudden signs. Learn fast. F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time. Time to call 911 immediately. The sooner they get to the hospital, the sooner they'll get treatment. And that can make a remarkable difference in their recovery. Learn the body language, the sudden signs, and spot a stroke fast.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
And we're back. Thank you again for tuning in to the Stan Watson Show. I'm your host, Stan Watson, along with my co-host, Samantha Caldwell. We are ready to go to work. You ready?
Yeah, I am ready. I'm ready.
I understand we have a new entrepreneur in our community.
That's right.
And her name is Natasha Bobby. Did I say that right?
Yes, sir.
And let me make sure I got the nail bar correct. Is it Impenix?
Impenix.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm trying to spell and my phonetic was just terrible here. Say it one more time.
Impenix.
Yes. Okay, well, great. Tell me about Impenix.
All right, Impenix is Atlanta's hottest new nail bar.
Hottest new, okay.
The hottest new thing in Atlanta.
And it just so happens to be right here in DeKalb County in Tucker, Georgia.
Tucker.
Yes.
That's in my district, okay.
The concept is it's not your average nail salon experience. It's very upscale, very luxury, and we aim to pamper you. Part of the name, Nix, is a Greek goddess, so we want to treat you like a goddess. We want you to come in, and we're going to pamper you. We're going to serve you the complimentary wine. And we're just going to make you have
you
a
whole... You said it's a nail bar.
It
the
is.
End. Okay.
Yeah, right. Emphasis on bar.
I see.
Okay,
let me write,
with the wine.
Let me underline that. Okay, nail bar. Now, when are you actually opening?
So we actually opened in February, but we're having a re-grand opening this coming Saturday, June the 20th from 10 to 3.
10 to 3,
And the purpose of the re-grand opening is because right now, we're kind of like Atlanta's best kept secret, but we don't want to be a secret.
Right.
We want
you're letting it out.
To know about us.
Awesome.
So we're going to have a re-grand opening just to revamp, reintroduce, and try to gain a lot more exposure.
Oh,
everyone
awesome.
Who finds out about Impenix is just blown away by the whole ambiance and the quality of service. And so we want everyone to have an opportunity to experience that.
Sounds
good. Wow, that does sound, and your nails look amazing.
I wore these bright colors.
Oh man, they look great. Let's show those.
Those are bright colors.
I love bright colors.
Okay, all right, it looks pretty bright.
I know, and so now Stan, the question I have for you, and, and how much would a gift certificate be for someone like a guest, a co-host or something like that, if Stan were thinking about doing something really incredibly nice for, how much would your gift certificates?
Because you're awesome and you deserve the works.
Oh my goodness.
And so we have what we call a Neeks package.
Okay.
Neeks package. Works.
Okay.
And so Mr. Stan, you need to just go ahead and give her
The Neeks.
And when's your birthday again? I had to make sure. When's your birthday?
My birthday's not till January.
Okay, we'll do that in January. That's what I thought.
Oh,
okay.
Man.
We'll make it work. Now where are you located in Tucker?
We're off of Hugh Howell Road.
Okay.
Hugh
Howell
and Heritage Place Plaza.
Okay.
Excellent. I know where Hugh Howell is. Now tell me, I guess your concept or the thought pattern for this type of nail bar. I mean, what are we thinking?
I actually adopted the entire concept pretty much from a popular nail bar in California.
California. Okay.
Yes. The nail industry in California is on a whole nother level. Mm-hmm. And so, of course, Atlanta is becoming the Hollywood of the South.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And so I said, you know what? Atlanta needs this. Mm-hmm. And this will be perfect.
Now, are you from California?
I am not. Am an Atlanta native. So.
Okay, okay.
But you visited and saw this concept.
Absolutely. And I was like, this would be perfect in my city, you know, because Atlanta is awesome. Atlanta is on the rise. We're, you know.
The Hollywood of the South.
Exactly.
So, build it, they will come.
Exactly. Now, how many technicians do you have there?
Currently, right now, we have about 8 male technicians. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's quite a few.
Absolutely.
Wow.
And it's unisex, so you're looking for guys to come in as well as young
Absolutely.
Ladies.
We have a pedicure just for men. It's called
pedicure just for
Zeus.
Men.
Zeus. The Zeus. So you know
that's
what?
Okay,
when's your birthday?
Right
we'll do that. I'll get
my
you the Zeus.
See how you are.
My birthday. Yours just passed. That's why I'm figuring I can get in on that.
She's trying to get me. That's okay. Now, is it affordable? You know, every time we bring something to California, the juicers and all that kind of stuff, it's a little bit higher in Atlanta. Are you affordable?
That is the whole niche of Input Neeks. Okay. Although you have this luxury ambiance and decor and experience, the niche of it is that our prices are very comparable. Mm-hmm. It's not that one person can come here and another person cannot.
Okay.
Everyone is welcome. Hence the reason why I also decided to place the business in DeKalb County, because when you walk in, you will automatically expect something of this fashion to be in Buckhead.
Okay.
You know, but I wanted to offer something in DeKalb County so that everyone can experience this luxury nail bar,
luxury.
And yet
like
it has, it has comparable prices. So why not come here?
Yeah, that's great.
Go down the street when I
can
come
can go here and
be
treated nice.
Well, we have a lot of viewers that live in DeKalb County, and especially from the church community.
Absolutely.
So I'm hoping that they will come out and do it.
Yes.
I have to ask the question. Give me some of the service. I know you said pedicure for men, you're going to pamper the Zeus treatment, and you got something for the ladies.
Neeks.
The Neeks with the name.
The Neeks.
So what else can I do? I mean, you gonna do eyebrow arching? What are you gonna do?
Absolutely.
Tell me what you gonna do.
We have a lot of a la carte services.
Not that I want one. I'm just saying.
Yeah, I was like, Shane, you barely have any brows.
No.
We have eyebrows. We do the eyelashes.
Okay.
We contract with someone that offers massages.
Oh,
so
man,
we're
not
a one stop shop. You're gonna come here and you can
get treated.
Spend the whole day here and get pampered.
That's a spa treatment there.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
Absolutely.
Now, he mentioned the different types of services. Mm-hmm. Why don't you tell them just by name some of the packages? Because you did say you have packages that are named.
I'll be touching on the Neeks package since it's hence Neeks, the name. Mm-hmm. And with our Neeks combo, manicure and pedicure, it's pretty much the work. You're going to get your body butter, your
body butter.
Scrub, your
sugar scrub,
sea salt soap, you're going to get a hot towel wrap, and you're also going to get the paraffin dip for your hands and your feet. So
yes.
It's just mine are dry too.
Oh my goodness, okay, so facials and all that kind of stuff?
Oh yes, absolutely. We have someone that does facials as well.
This is great.
This sounds great. I may have to just come see you then.
Yeah, check it out. Now you should check it out first.
You want me to check it out first?
Yeah.
Okay. You want me to go first?
Yeah, get you.
You come
they said that they have stuff for guys.
Right.
So you check it out first, and then that way we'll be able to let the viewers know what's going on.
I will do that. I can come by this area, not for all.
Manicure. You do manicures.
We'll see what we can get done. All right. So we talked about who's watching the show. Who would be your clientele beside the Hollywood stars or persons that might be moving into Atlanta?
Everyone.
That's what I wanted you to say. So anyone can come see you.
Anyone. Mm-hmm. We want everyone.
There are a lot of kids now. I have a 13-year-old, and they're doing nails as well. So do you ask, I asked the question, can kids come and see you as well?
Absolutely. We actually have a package called Princess, Little Princess.
Oh,
it's for the little girls. Princess. And we actually have something special just for them. We have the cotton candy and the bubblegum sugar scrub.
I want the princess.
Like
bubblegum.
Cotton candy and bubblegum. Yes.
Nice.
Just for the princess.
So can they rent you out for all the little princesses for
a birthday party? Yes, that would be great.
Oh, okay. Absolutely. Right. We do princess parties. We have meets parties for the adults. We have
a meets party.
You can bring your bridal party. Whatever the occasion, we do offer parties. Yeah.
This is awesome. I think.
You are a hidden secret, I believe. Yeah.
But we don't want to be a secret.
Yeah, let it out. Let people know.
Exactly.
That's awesome.
So now, what have been your marketing program so far? I understand that this is a grand reopening.
Yeah.
And so we're here on the Stand Watching. I'm sure some people will come by. Matter of fact, y'all got to go by and say that I saw this young lady on the Stand Watching show.
Yeah.
And you won't get no break now, but I'm just saying that just say you saw me on the Stand.
Yeah, just mention it. No discount. Okay.
She's in business right now, okay? So make sure you go by and say that you saw her on the Stand Watching show. Are you doing newspaper or radio ads, anything? What are you doing to get out the word?
Yes, I've done some radio promos with Radio One.
Okay.
We're also getting into the print media. We're going to do some advertising in Crossroads as well as the local papers in Tucker.
Okay.
Tucker AJC, someone from the AJC should be coming to the re-grand opening. So every avenue that I can think of to get the word out there and to gain more exposure, that's what we're doing right now.
What about those young ladies that's in sororities and old men that are in fraternities?
Absolutely.
You ought to have a special day for them.
And we're working on all of it. We are.
We're trying to help you get the money. Okay.
Yeah.
So that's good because there are a lot of working people in the fraternity sorority in DeKalb
County.
That's
true.
Absolutely.
And they are part of every volunteering.
Like that,
yes.
And I know you mentioned your daughter, who's 13, but we also just did a campaign for prom where I actually did a prom giveaway where we gave away a prom dress and just a total package.
The
prom dress, a gift card to eat, everything, you know.
Oh my goodness, that sounds awesome. Now, before we let you go, you got to take some time to tell us how we can get to you via your phone number, your website, and most of all, I want them to know where the address is in Tucker. I got to find it myself.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
Okay. So we're Infamy's Nail Bar located in Tucker, Georgia. The address is 4450 Hugh Howell Road. We're in Suite 12, and that's Tucker, Georgia, 30084. You can also visit us online at www.impenix.com, and Impenix is E-M-P-E-N-Y-X. We're also on social media at Impenix Nail Bar.
Excellent. Impenix.
Impenix.
And you said based on the Greek culture, you said?
Well, it's something that I put together. Nix is a Greek goddess.
That's right. Okay.
The EMP is short for Empyrean, which is like a form of paradise. So when you come into Impenix, we want you to feel like you're in paradise.
Excellent.
And we're going to pamper you like a goddess.
All right. Well, Natasha, I wish you so much luck.
Our
first guest has been Natasha Bobbitt, and she said Impenix is doing a grand opening, a re-grand opening this Saturday, which is June the 20th.
Yes.
And it's from 10 to 3 p.m.
Yes.
And you ask them, everybody come out.
Everyone come
out. Okay, can I get a free hot dog or something? I'm just kidding.
Got you.
No, she's like, we'll make it work. Well, thank you for coming by. This is a very good concept.
This has been great.
California comes to Atlanta in a different form.
Just
not film and music, but also now we get some of the culture, some of the amenities that California has.
There you go.
Now, you're
from Atlanta?
I am.
So you just visited to see what was going on.
Yeah, I might need to get a touch up.
We'll take care of the touch up next time. Natasha, thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
Did I get a phone number from you for my viewing audience?
Oh, yeah.
Before you leave, please.
The phone number is 770 797-5984.
Excellent. We'll take a quick break. Our guest has been Natasha Bobbitt. She's the owner of Empanique's Nail Bar, a California-style nail bar right here in Decatur, DeKalb County, Georgia. Go by and see her. Thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
We'll come by and see you.
Yes, please.
And
do.
I may pay half on it so she can come by and see you as well.
$10.
All right, we'll take a quick break. Stay right there, Samantha, and I'll be right back.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
You say you'd give your right arm to be there for your family? Here's your chance to prove it. Have your blood pressure checked and control it to lower your risk of heart attack and stroke.
Comcast Studio 25.
Body language. Without saying a word, it can tell you so much. Like someone is having a stroke. Know the sudden signs. Learn fast. F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time. Time to call 911 immediately. The sooner they get to the hospital, the sooner they'll get treatment, and that can make a remarkable difference in their recovery. Learn the body language, sudden signs, and spot a stroke fast.
When you throw away money on wasted electricity, you're throwing away everything you could have bought with it. Saving energy saves you money. Learn more at energysavers.gov.
And we are back right here on the Stan Watson Show. I am your co-host, Samantha Cardwell. So glad to be with you this evening. Had a wonderful guest on the first half.
Yeah, California style nail bar.
Yeah, Cali in the house.
I got to go by and see that.
Yeah, definitely. Well, we are bringing another great guest. We have with us Mr. Benjamin Austin. He is an author and also the founder and visionary behind ECRA Growth and Educational Services, Inc.
Excellent.
Welcome, Mr. Austin.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here.
So nice to have you.
Nice for having me.
Yeah. Well, so we understand that you are an author. I think that may be where it all started. So why don't you tell us a little bit more about that book?
It is. I am an author, but this particular book or product is by my daughter, who's an author.
Okay.
She became an author at the age of 9 years of age.
Wow.
I produced the book. She was the youngest African-American author published through the Library of Congress at that then age, mm-hmm. book entitled What Every Child Should Know About Prayer from a Child's Point of View.
Wow, that's great.
Her business name is ECRA.
Okay, so it's not ECRA to say it, it's actually the acronym.
Absolutely.
Okay.
ECRA, mm-hmm. ECRA Growth and Educational mm-hmm. Services, Inc.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Awesome. And ECRA standing for Esther's Covenant and Ruth's Abundance.
Absolutely.
Tell us a little bit more about that background, mm-hmm. how you came up with that acronym.
Well, you know, Ms. Austin.
Go ahead.
The author's name is Erica.
Erica.
Okay.
Austin.
Okay.
And the ECA. And so the most prominent women of the Bible at the time was Esther and Ruth. So I put the initials ECRA with my daughter's name, Erica C. Austin, which is a middle name, and R from one of the nicknames that one of her friends called at the time. And I just came up with the concept ECRA Growth and Educational Services, which for Esther's Covenant, Ruth's Abundance, because her being a girl child mm-hmm. and those prominent women were prominent women that did a phenomenal thing through those biblical times.
That's right.
Sure.
So I established the name and the concept through the Holy Spirit
mm-hmm.
and came up with ECRA
all sunk together.
Mm-hmm. That's biblical. I mean, he did.
Esther
saved her people mm-hmm. by talking to her uncle Mordecai.
Yeah.
And then Ruth stayed with her mother-in-law when everybody else was ready to leave.
Right. Right.
How about that? I went to Sinus School.
Awesome. I appreciate you. I knew
he knows a couple of things. Just a couple. Don't quiz him now because you get lost there.
I like that.
You like that.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So now your organization was established back in 1998.
Yes.
What have you been doing with the organization since you've started it?
Well, actually, I became regional distribution director for ECRA, which is my daughter's business. You're not nine forever. She became a college grad, went to Howard University and grad.
Well, I was going to say, how old is she now?
She's a young adult now.
Yeah, uh-huh.
Master also 2013. She now resides in Maryland and works in D.C.
Okay.
So being that we established this concept back in, at the time, it was for timeless. It wasn't just for that moment.
Mm-hmm.
So now we are branding more the concept of ECRA Growth and Educational Services.
Sure.
Erica grew up here in Atlanta, went to school over in DeKalb County.
Okay.
Was excellent, earned excellent.
What high school did she attend?
She attended Norcross. We did move to Norcross at that time after, we did move over. But she accumulated over 300 to 400 academic awards during her school tenure.
300 to 400?
Yes, absolutely. And the concept is because she was able to earn those type of awards, she was able to write. So the concept was to, she became an inspirational, motivational speaker, highly sought after, exposure to TV and radio. People were saying, where can we find this girl? We heard on the TV, radio, and she's very intelligent, speaks well. Can we get her to speak to our kids?
Excellent.
Yeah.
Now, is this her book you said again?
It is
this
her
book. This is
her
book. Don't get a shot of the book. Now, this is her book, and this book was published again when?
We revised the book in 2013 through Author House. It's been revised. It's been reappraised and re-edited.
Okay.
Colors and things of that nature.
But, it was her
but the original book was back in 98?
Absolutely.
That's what I was getting to. Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Yeah.
And that back in 1998. And the title again is what?
What Every Child Should Know About Prayer from a Child's Point of View, Inspired by the Holy Spirit of God for All of His Precious Children.
Okay.
Oh, that's
so
awesome.
If you had a young adult that wanted to have this read to their child, boy child or girl child, what could they expect from the book?
Well, first of all, the concept is to allow teach kids to apply biblical principles through prayer.
Okay.
Also learn how to overcome conflict through forgiving, which is the first chapter.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
You have kids that are either only child or have brothers and sisters. So you have those only child concept of what my daughter was going through, what she was experiencing being the only child, which she was.
She was the only child, yep. Okay.
And what it was like if she had brothers and sisters through her friends. So she talks about then, of course, she was grew up in the church, so she talks about her experience in church and trusting God, prosper, you know, just being prosperous and prayer. Let's see, forgive and stand in church. God love lasts forever.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's just some really great concepts in there.
Those
very easy,
are great.
Easy to read concepts and teachings.
Mm-hmm. Right, and it seems like it was an easy read for young adults as well and for
Absolutely.
Children as well. Mm-hmm. Have you been able to get the book into churches or to, well, maybe not school, but into the religious community? How has that been accepted?
We have attempted to, and of course, mm-hmm. we haven't had the total Mm-hmm. you know,
buy-in yet.
Buy-in, which is why we're still here.
Yeah. which is why we're here today.
Right, right. Everything comes together, you know,
right.
comes together.
Okay,
but we've had great success. We do a lot of marketing, community events, church events, mm-hmm. and we are independent. We were able to get the book published through it ourselves. We own rights to it. We own 100%
sure.
of the proceeds, so we're able to give back. Mm-hmm. And actually, we are actually seeking initiatives. Campaigns to partner with organizations mm-hmm. that are looking to raise monies for whatever reason they need to.
And they can utilize the book in that process.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
This is a really great concept.
Thank you very much.
And one of DeKalb County's own.
Absolutely. Now talk a little bit about your the other initiative that we were talking about, where you're actually in the community with this initiative that was used the acronyms. For Erica,
ECRA.
For your daughter, ECRA. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about that and how we can be a part of that, or the community at whole could be a part of that.
Well, what we like, we really want, because a lot of, even though we've sold a great number of books, mm-hmm. what a lot of people still haven't been exposed to it. And what our concept is to make sure that our kids are seeing authors that look like mm-hmm. themselves, mm-hmm. that they inspire and motivate them, that they can do and accomplish whatever they set their minds to do. Also with family support. Mm-hmm. This was a team effort. This was an effort by my daughter and her dad, mm-hmm. you know. She had the talent, I had the vision. We took it and we ran with it. So mm-hmm. while we were out there campaigning and giving back, but we wanted people to see how this whole thing came about.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
It was about family, love, taking a talent and making something out of it. And a lot of times we overlook the talents that our kids have by looking for big things. A lot of big things are made through small developments.
Yep. That's right.
So you want to make sure you didn't overlook her talent and try to embellish her talent and show that you cared about it.
Exactly.
That's
giving her love
great.
That as a dad. Number one, mm-hmm. it's his Father's Day week.
That's mm-hmm. right.
And a dad who raised this young lady as a single parent at
mm-hmm.
that time.
Okay.
So giving back, it's a lot that goes into this book other than just the book.
Right.
A dad and raising his kids, being focused
mm-hmm.
and making sure you give her something that she can take and go. A legacy, for instance, mm-hmm. I want to leave a legacy that whatever happens to me, I still gave something to my daughter she can take and remember me mm-hmm. by.
Right.
And also family generations to come with those kids that are coming up, they can see, well, we want to be like Erica. We want to mm-hmm. do what Erica and her dad did.
Mm-hmm.
So we can give them something to be motivated and inspired.
So push them and boost them a little bit.
Yes, sir.
Now talk about your educational services with the initiative. I mean, what type of services are we offering to the community that they can take a full, you know, control and see what they can do to make their lives better?
Well, what we want to offer, number one, motivation. We
motivation.
Would like to get in front of kids and also promote and encourage academic excellence. Make mm-hmm. sure our kids understand mm-hmm. the value of school. Make mm-hmm. sure they understand the value of reading.
Mm-hmm.
Reading is very, very important.
Very
you know,
important.
This young lady was able to write because she was able to read.
Mm-hmm.
And making sure our kids are learning to read and establish that at an early age so when they go off to higher education, mm-hmm. they'll be disciplined. Mm-hmm. This young lady graduated, for instance, summa cum laude, some kind of that cum laude thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
And one of those cum laudes.
Something like that. I paid the fake tuition and she was getting the Pilates, okay?
Right,
so,
right.
you know, that's pretty cool.
She's paying like the
Pilates.
Yeah,
only cum laude.
Yeah. And pina colada for
me. Right, that's right. Yeah, the cum laude for her, right?
Yeah. But that's what we want to do. We want to encourage, make sure our kids are being exposed to what matters today.
Sure.
Economic growth, initiative to encourage our kids to and families to start businesses at an early age
now,
so they could contribute and create jobs.
Mm-hmm.
You just what we saw what happened some years ago, and we need mm-hmm. to start creating more jobs in our community. We need to start creating jobs. You just never know what small can grow large, and you're putting people to work, mm-hmm. and you're making a difference in other people's lives.
Okay.
It's giving something back that's bigger than, don't just include just you.
That's right.
Right,
First initiative you said, so then you're making a model, so you encourage them. What else are you trying to teach them?
Learning how to overcome conflict. Mm-hmm. Number one, by the principal.
Bullying problem.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, bullies and all of that. Learn how to bring it down, but also learning how to say, you know what, I apologize, I'm sorry, excuse me, I forgive, so we can cut down and maybe minimize the violence.
Well, and that's what I was, that was one of the things, as soon as you said it, what came to mind was violence in the community and really taking those levels down, which is also something across the front, you know, in terms of when we teach kids how to resolve problems in ways that are nonviolent, speaking to one another, forgiving one another.
Yes, yes.
You know, sometimes it's not even about who's right.
Right.
Just that's just forgive and keep
ever
moving.
Totally right.
Yeah. Right.
There's always different ways.
Yes, Stan. I've told you.
I'm writing down.
I'm right.
I'm writing down that I'm not always right, but Samantha's never right.
Exactly. Exactly. So now let's do this on the screen.
I wrote it so.
And we forgive each other for that.
Right. I
forgive you. Keep it moving. You know,
we keep it moving.
Absolutely.
Is there any other principle that we can look forward to in the book or in your platform that you have for our young adults?
I think one of the, again, the forgiving thing is the one that most prevalent right now with all the stuff that's going on in communities. That we want to teach these kids early on how to overcome conflict, even within your families. You know, you grow up and I don't like my sister, I don't like my brother, and I don't like my mom, I don't like my dad.
Yes,
it's like 30 years ago.
Yeah,
we're still holding on to it. So we want to do that, but we also want to make sure kids with the concept that they are seeing their talent, that they, whatever it may be, and that just to trust God.
Yes,
sure.
Right,
trust God through it all, and be at an early age to know that it's something out here bigger than you, and you have a purpose for your life.
That sounds awesome.
Can we tap in just real quickly to the 300 different awards and accolades that she had got during school? How kids, I mean, are you showing kids how to do things like that? Because I'm sure that's the platform, or at least a segue into getting scholarships and that
learning
type of thing.
Learning to read and being encouraged.
And Mr. Watson, just in kindergarten, learning to read, pick up a book.
Right.
You know, it's amazing because as we travel and do book events and everything, and a lot of times I see parents and they ask the kid, do you want this book? You never ask a kid, do you want this book? Because what are they going to say?
Yeah, right.
We're reading this book for the summer.
Yeah, and you buy it and you read it to them. So we want to make sure that we, I kind of got away from your question. I apologize.
No, that's okay.
Well, she received junior beta, accelerated readers.
Okay.
Those are awards that are going on in school today. You want to make sure your kids are getting accelerated reader program, junior beta clubs, anything that has to do with reading, or even if it's math, whatever program.
Well, see, reading helps you with math and science.
Yeah, we talked about this on another show. Right. That's exactly. You've got to know how to read in order to solve problems.
Ding, ding, ding.
And also, one thing that reading does is also give our kids a positive self-esteem in speaking to an audience.
Right.
Ah.
Okay, when you're reading, this little girl was going through books. She was reading 3, 4, 5, 6 books a week. And I'm like, how, when, and how do you do this? I had no idea. She was teaching me things that I didn't know, because when you read, you really increases your awareness of a lot of different things, and it comes through reading. So we want to make sure our kids are learning that reading, academic excellence, take it serious, because your future, you're not going to be a kid forever.
And at an early age, take advantage of this.
Early age,
absolutely.
Excellent. Well, this sounds awesome. I hope that we get out in the community with this. Before we let you go, can you tell us how we can get in touch with you, if there's a website, and how we can get the book? If you look right here and tell us that, we appreciate that.
Well, you can. There's a website. The website is, of course, www.ericaaustin, that's ericaaustin.com, which is a website that puts you in touch with all our info. My contact number is area 678-396-9088, 678-396-9088. Again, the web is ericaaustin.com, ericaaustin.com.
Excellent.
Awesome.
We're glad to have you come by our show tonight.
Okay.
And hopefully the word will get out to our viewing audience and to the community. Very special. And when your daughter comes to town,
We want to see her. That's what I was just thinking.
We're going to see her on the show. So bring her to the show.
Absolutely.
You don't even have to have an appointment. So she's in
town.
Show
just
up.
Drop on
we'll
in.
We'll give her 3 or 5 minutes.
Yeah, we'll take some time off your time.
That's right. And we'll make sure that she can be the co-host.
Ooh.
Ooh, that was funny. No, seriously, come by and we'll make sure. I really would love to meet her and see who she is and make sure it works. Well, our guest has been Mr. Benjamin Austin. He's a children's author, but he also does a lot with the initiatives we we call it?
The ECRA.
ECRA.
Growth and Educational Services,
Excellent.
Inc.
Inc. All right, well, good. Yes, we'll take a quick break. We come back. We got some musical guests. I'm going to interview them first. And they're been referred by my co-host, Samantha. So she said that they can sing. They are awesome. Outstanding, magnanimous, I mean, lovely, you know, gifted. I mean, that's what she said.
All of those words
all
and more.
And above. So we're going to take a quick break to come back, and we're going to be talking to our musical guests, Joshua Israel and the Tribe. So stay right there. Promise you, Samantha and I will be right back.
The smallest moments can have the biggest impact on a child's life. Take time to be a dad today.
You say you'd give your right arm to be there for your family? Here's your chance to prove it. Have your blood pressure checked and control it to lower your risk of heart attack and stroke.
We're gonna take a break.
Ready? Here we go.
All right, we're back with the Stan Watson
Show.
Love
that music.
I love the music as well. It was all up on me.
Stan, you got roll with it, man. You should be dancing when that happens.
Dancing with that, but I had such a great interview with the author over here, Mr. Benjamin Austin. That was awesome. Yeah. I can't wait to meet his daughter.
I know.
I want to make sure that happens
as
well.
She's doing some mighty awesome
things. Mighty big things. Cum laude, she said.
Yeah.
No. Okay.
We're going to leave that alone.
Got a couple of announcements for you. Join me this Friday, June the 19th at Sugar Creek Golf Course. It's our 18th annual Father's Day Golf Tournament. It's at 2706 Boulder Crest Road, right off of 285. Our 18th year. We have some great recipients this year. We'll be giving a check over to the Tabitha House and also a check to the Porter Sanford Foundation.
Oh,
and so this is on the 19th. It's not going to rain. It's going to be hot. So come out. Registration starts at 8 a.m. in the morning. And we have a shotgun start at 9 o'clock. And we probably have our awards at 3 o'clock. So make sure you come over to our 18th annual Father's Day Golf Tournament. And also, my good friend David Manuel over at the Porter Sanford Performing Arts Center is having a 5K Father's Day run. And it also occurs this Saturday, June the 20th at 9 p.m. You can give David a call over to Porter Sanford Foundation, and he will tell you about that. But make sure you come by and see me Friday for our 18th annual Father's Day Golf Tournament. Takes place at Sugar Creek Golf Course, and we'll make sure that you come out and see it. As we speak, the polls have closed. There was a special election today to fill the seat in District 5.
Okay.
I understand that there were 10 candidates, and so only one person can win. So who did, I guess the person that did not receive 51% or 50 plus one, it will be a runoff.
Okay.
So please call me at 770-555-559-2999. I was trying to get District 5 out. 770-559-2999. If you know any results, you can give me a call tonight and let me know who's leading in the race.
Right now.
It's over 140,000 people in District 5, so you got to come out and vote. The polls are closed. I predicted a runoff, so I'm not sure, but we'll see what happens tonight. But if anybody has any information, the polls closed an hour ago. We'll make it work as well.
Let's do it.
We have a musical guest?
Yes, we do. And I am so excited about introducing this next guest. It is Joshua Israel and the Tribe, and they are amazing.
Excellent.
You know, we've been talking a lot on the show about family values and, of course, you know, having biblical principles in place. Joshua and his tribe actually represent both. This is his family that he has with him, his tribe.
So the tribe and the family.
His
Yeah. Well, welcome, Joshua.
Just part of his family. This isn't everybody, but this is a part of them.
I saw some of the other family members. Okay. Yes. They are going to be cheering them on in a few minutes. Welcome to Stan Watson Show. Tell me about Joshua, and then we'll talk about the tribe and the family.
Joshua.
Okay, old preacher kid. Where are you from, Joshua?
Born in Missouri, but I'm a Georgia boy. I've been here since I was two, so born
excellent.
In St. Louis. Georgia, the west side of Atlanta.
Okay, the west side of Atlanta.
Yes.
Now tell me about your tribe that you have with you as well.
Tribe.
Samantha said they are ready to go.
Yeah,
they are.
The tribe consists of my four older children. I have seven. My father's seven. And so I'm four teenagers.
You got a tribe, Joshua. You said seven. Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
Four girls and three boys or some young men.
And some young men. They're growing up now.
But it's all right. They always be my boys. So.
Well, make sure you introduce them. Tell me who you have with you.
Yes, sir. Well, we have, I'll start with my elders on keys. It's LaTuan,
how you doing? Okay. How old are you, LaTuan? I'm great. How old are you? You 19? You don't look like you're 19 years old. You be 21.
They have that youth going for them. That youth look.
Oh my goodness! Oh man, you look like you're about 15 or 16 years old. You fooling me? Okay. Who else you have with you?
My eldest daughter,
Deja Monet.
Deja Monet. I like that. Okay. Hold the mic up, Deja Monet, and tell me how old are you?
I'm 18.
Oh.
He has some wonderful kids.
All right, who's the next one over there, Samantha?
I'm gonna let them introduce themselves.
All right, who's
Joshua Nicole.
Say it one more time.
Joshua Nicole.
Joshua.
Joshiana.
Joshiana. Okay.
Joshia.
Joshia.
It's Joshia. A strange one. Yeah, it's something that came up.
Daddy.
Oh,
Dancing came up with that. All right, and how old are you?
17.
What?
Yes.
Y'all got some great genes. I mean, can I believe this?
Okay, he look like he's 10.
Oh,
come on now.
Okay. All right. And the last on drum. What's your name?
Isaiah.
Okay, I can do that one, Isaiah. Thank you, Isaiah. Appreciate that. How old are you? 15. Yeah, so he got tired of those names. He said, Isaiah.
You going to ask Joshua how old he is, or can he pass?
No, Joshua will pass on that.
I'm 20, man.
No, he's 20. His son, 19
nice.
Or 20.
Nice.
Well, Samantha said you were great. Tell me a little bit about your music before we bring you back to perform.
Just just original music. Always have done original music. I've been leading praise and worship for over 16 years.
Okay.
When I started leading worship, God began to give me songs, man. And just all, I know it's cliche, but all, you know, mm-hmm. Holy Spirit inspired. And
Excellent. Just
put it down the way he gave it to me.
All right, before we let you minister, I know Samantha probably got one other question
before we let you go. I have one awesome question.
Go right here.
Joshua, I know you have a testimony that you share most times when you minister.
Yes,
and
sir.
If you can tell us real quickly, ma'am, what that testimony is.
Excellent.
Sure. At the age of 11, I was found dead, hanging in a tree, lifeless.
No.
I climbed up a neighborhood tree out in Red Oak Apartments in College Park, Georgia, and came in contact with a power line, and touched that power line, and that power line grabbed me and didn't let me go until it was done, electrocuted me to death, and they found me hanging by one leg, lifeless. Mm. And the paramedics arrived, and of course, I had to bring out the defibrillators and all that. And doctors, so many miracles that day happened. You know, they say it was a wonder that I didn't suffer tremendous brain damage because I was over 45 minutes unconscious.
Oh, really?
And so, you know, but God stepped in. We all know that God had the final say.
Always
so.
On
so.
Yeah,
he stepped in, and I spent a month in intensive care down at Grady. But nevertheless, they told me I wouldn't have children, but I have 7 children, and, mm-hmm. and I've been on my wife since we were 10.
That you do. He has 7 children. I can approve that. They're out in the hall. I'm going to bring them in before we finish.
They've been married for 17 years, and actually, me and her knew each other at the time. She was in the tree with me right before I got electrocuted. So.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
That's an awesome testimony.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Well, wonderful. There's no strangeness to what God can do.
That's
no,
awesome.
Well, we want to take a quick break and come back, and what song you going to do for us?
Show up and show out. Because
show
that's
up
what
and
God's
show out.
Doing
All
life.
Right, you watch the Stand Watch Show. Samantha and I will be right back with Joshua and the tribe. Stay right there.
We are back right here on the music set. We have Joshua, Israel, and the tribe, and they are going to show up and show out. That's the next song.
Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3, go!
Bless the home, mend the broken, right the wrong, strengthen the weak, cover the meek, serve the enemy, his defeat, heal the family, bless the home, mend the broken, right the wrong, strengthen the weak, Lord, cover the meek, serve the devil, his defeat, show up, show out, oh yeah.
Do what you do to crush people to shout.
Come on,
show up, come. Show out, do like only you can erase all.
What you say?
Show up, show out.
Oh yeah.
Do what you do to crush people.
Y'all ready to DeKalb County? Y'all
show
ready?
Up, show
we gonna go to the Bible
like
right here.
You can erase.
Listen, you rain down fire on the prophets of Baal. When it's all over, everybody can tell that you're the one and only true and living God. Every other God ain't nothing but a fraud. Can't nobody do what you can. Can't nobody do what you've done. So
let my God arise.
Woo! Show up, show out. Say it now.
Show up, show out.
Somebody talk to him.
Show up, show out.
In our home.
Show up, show out.
In our family.
Show up, show out.
All over the world.
Show up, show out.
All over the world.
Show up, show out.
All over the world.
Show up, show out.
Let me hear you say,
I ain't too proud to beg.
Come on.
I ain't too proud to beg.
What you say?
I ain't too proud to beg.
What you say?
I ain't too proud to beg.
Come on, say,
I ain't too proud.
You gotta be humble before
I
the Lord.
Ain't too proud to beg.
You gotta humble yourself
I
before
ain't
the
too
Lord.
Proud to beg.
Come on.
I ain't too proud to beg.
Somebody say, Lord, I really need you.
Oh. Lord, I really need you.
How bad do you need him?
Lord, I really need you.
How bad do you need him?
Lord, I really need you.
He says, try him.
Lord, I really need you.
Prove him.
Lord, I really need you.
And see what he do.
Lord, I really need you.
You tell him.
Lord, I really need you.
Show up. Show up. Oh.
Right here on the music set, man, we are just dancing and going at it. Listen, we want to see you at the golf tournament on this Saturday.
Friday.
I thought it was...
No, Friday.
Okay. Friday. Sorry. Yeah. Sorry.
Please on don't show up Saturday.
Please don't come on Saturday. Right. On Friday, we'll see you at the golf tournament, and we're going to have Joshua Israel and the tribe take us out with I'll Praise You Anyway.
Praise you anyway. Oh.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, there are times in your life where you just have to learn to praise God in spite of what's going on, in spite of what you're going through. You got to get an anyway praise in you. Yeah. Father, we just want to say thank you for being such a good God to us. We ask you to look past our faults today, God, but we're going to praise you anyway. I'll praise you anyway. I'll praise you anyway. I'll praise you anyway, Lord. Oh, I'll praise you anyway. Help me sing it, daughters. I'll praise you anyway. Oh. Praise you.
Praise you anyway.
Listen now. So trouble surrounds me, and all I see seems so discouraging. But as I look back over my life, I'm reminded of how you've never left me. Oh, so although I am faced, yes I am, faced with many hard trials, oh Lord, I said I've made up my mind that praise, I will not deny you. Oh, when I praise
you anyway,
somebody tell the Lord,
I'll praise you anyway.
I'll praise you, yeah.
Praise you anyway.
Yes, I will.
Lord, I'll praise you anyway.
Can I be real honest right here? Listen. See, life can be so hard. Get so hard to make you ask, where is God? And trouble can be so blinding. Have you forget what God has already brought you from? Hey! See, but I just live by faith. Anybody know what I'm talking about? And not by what they see. Oh, yeah. So although things don't go in your way, I said, I'll praise you anyway. Somebody say, said, I'll
praise you anyway.
Somebody make up their mind right now. That in spite of what you're going through, you're going to praise them anyway. Somebody praise their way through the situation. And you come to that place and you tell them these words. Say, through the heartache, through the pain, yeah. Through the storm and through the rain, oh God. Through situations and tribulation, my God, I'll praise you. See whether I'm single, if I'm well, yeah. See whether I'm rich or if I am poor, oh God. See if I'm way, way, way down in the valley, Lord. Yeah, I praise you. Somebody lift their hands and say, I praise you. Oh. Father, I made up my mind that I'll praise you anyway. Yeah. Hallelujah.